I don't identify as, you know, anything but being cisgender, heterosexual, male, you know, those are, that's how I identify. But I guess my intersection with there is around race, right? So like, I know that when I tell a white person, and a white American person, your America is very different from mine, they can't, a lot of them can't wrap their brain around that because the oppression is invisible to them, right?
Shout out to all the trainees out there.
You can't say that.
That's crazy.
Transgenders.
Oh, transgenders.
Yeah. So you met a girl and she didn't tell you she was a transgender.
That ain't a girl. I met a boy. That means I met a boy.
We have to teach about gender because people think just because you're born with a penis, you're a man, and that's not true.
Stop defining us by genitalia. Because having a penis don't make you a man.
You're not going to tell me that this girl was born this way. That's all I'm gonna say. Like, you're not gonna tell me that.
You may see me as a female, but that's not what it is. And I can't get you to understand this because you don't understand what's going on inside.
No one can define that for you but yourself, what makes you a man, and no one can tell you different. Or a woman. Or if you are non-gender conforming. Whatever it is, no one can tell you who you are.
You gonna be ruined. You can't no black man stand up and say, oh, you know, my whole life, I felt like a woman, you know what I'm saying? But I was just holding it down for my kids and my bitch, you know what I'm saying? We say that shit, nigga, we gonna get assassinated, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying, by us.
We have done what the slave master did to us, dehumanize us, degrade us, demonize us, but then use them by our advantage.
We ain't finna be looking at you on the Wheaties box for all these years. You was a man's man, and then you get to come up there and say you want a punai and not a denai, you feel me?
It's hypocritical to talk about the Supreme Court and calling them Sodom and Gomorrah, but if that's the case, half our churches have been Sodom and Gomorrah for 100 years.
People may not want to change their deeply held beliefs, but I think that's even deeper, where it's like changing a deeply held belief just doesn't happen easily because your brain can't tell the difference between, you know, you challenge what my opinion on something and a bear is chasing me through the woods. You know, like, yeah. It's the same experience inside your brain. Yeah.
You are who you are when God made you, not who you became after he did. That's how I feel. You rebuking God, man. God ain't put them feelings in you, man. That's the devil playing tricks on your mind. That's a test from God.
Like a dude would beat you, sell you, rape you, sell your kids, but tell you about this God. I know for very few black atheists, there had to be something we believed in that got us through this moment, that got us through this brutality, that helped us be able to live through it. So the fact that you survived meant that maybe this thing, this being, this entity helped me do it. So I'm gonna pass that on to my kids.
You can't evangelize and antagonize at the same time.
And all these little boys, they look at that, and now they wearing dresses and stuff, and you know what I'm saying? Like, you got sitting there with big-ass man hands, and you know what I'm saying? Big-ass man arms and neck and shit, but you talking about my name, Kate, bitch. You know, that shit ain't gonna go. You know what I'm saying? I don't want little kids to be on that shit.
My name is Angel. I grew up in a Christian non-denominational household. Both of my parents are extremely religious. They specialized in street ministry. All my life, I felt like I never identified with my body. Everyone who surrounded me kept trying to fix me because I never identified with the culture of what it means to be a man.